Hey y'all, hey, and welcome to another episode of CEO Chatter. 90-day vlogging. I think I'm gonna do this more than 90 days. And I think I've said that more than once. So, what y'all been up to? Put it in the comments. I just got off of work. Home Depot. My last day is the 31st. So, I won't work next week because I'm going out of town. And I'll tell y'all about it. And then 2 weeks after that, I'll work there and then it's my last day. I am sad about it because there's so many people there that I love. And I've been waiting forever to do it. And then I just said, it's time. Well, God told me it was time. It wasn't my doing because I'll probably still be there if it wasn't God. To be honest with you, and I had to do it when I did it, and I had to put the date that I put. So those who know about God and stuff like that, you know what that's about. So today I went to lunch with my girlfriends, with some of my tribe. I have different tribes, different women that I hang around, and I absolutely just love them. All of the women I hang around, I absolutely adore them. I love them. They are pieces of me. So, I absolutely adore them. So, we went to lunch and we wrote down some stuff. We had an assignment, so we had to write down some things that we want to see God do. And I'm like in amazement, and I'm waiting. Like, I'm excited. There are some things that I'm just working on right now. And I'm just like, okay, God, I'm watching and waiting that He's putting in my spirit. So that's that. Have I ever showed y'all my plant? I'm trying to be a plant mom. Sleep. Arnitra bought me. Yeah, I still had the tags on the plants. Arnitra bought me a plant stand for my birthday. She be like, you ain't gonna use it. And I'm like, yes, I will. And then I have one over there. And all those were above my kitchen thing because I wanted them to drape down, but it didn't work out that way. Ignore my mess on my dining room table. And ignore my mess on my couch. And I have two over there. Those two, I have the test of time. Because they was in the hotel with me last year. So I've had them for over a year now. So what's going on? I have a client that I think I told you guys about. We're working on her brand. I'm like really, really excited about it because I'm doing a whole revamp for her. And we're working that through and we're developing templates. And she's like, sis, we gotta, excuse me, have templates. So whenever you have new clients, it'll be just easier. And I'm like, all right. And it's such amazing to have people by your side that want to be by your side, that want to help you, want to see you grow. Her and I was talking and I was telling her my plans for business and different things. And she was like, I'm going to retire you. I was like, okay, sis. And so that was like super, super dope. Did I tell y'all I got a part in a movie? Love and Drugs 3. Like, so excited about that. Like, so excited about it. So excited about it. The last role I had in the movie, I didn't have to audition for it. I was working for a film producer as her assistant. And my, the girl who was supposed to play the part backed out. And my boss was like, Anya, I need you to play this role. So that's how I got the other speaking role. And I am in another movie just as an extra. So Love and Drugs is like a big, I would say it's a big franchise out here in Dallas. And I'm excited to be working with DeMarcus Bailey, of JF Bailey Productions, I think that's what it's called. He produced some really good stuff. Nothing that's just that you just be like, ugh, I can't get through it because of the acting. Like, he don't produce garbage. So yeah. Oh, going back to today, I'll post the video, my TikTok app that I did of our video, of our picture. I don't know why I'm yawning so much, but that's whatever. I'm about to watch P-Valley. I've been watching P-Valley. So I'm about to do that. I have much to talk about. What else is going on? I'm drinking my apple cider vinegar tea in the morning, and I really noticed it curbs my appetite. Well, not so much my appetite, but my sugar cravings. And at night, I drank my green tea, so I'm gonna drink some green tea tonight. I didn't drink my apple cider vinegar earlier, and I could tell. Oh, tea earlier, but I can tell. But I'm gonna drink my green tea tonight. I'm eating some popcorn and drinking a Coke. I haven't had a Coke in forever. So that's about it. That's what I have going on. I just wanted to get on here and just chat it out with you guys. As you know, we have Theories and Thoughts podcast. You can catch shows here on this YouTube station and Swagger's YouTube station, or you can catch it live. Well, you can catch it live on the YouTubes or on Facebook, Swagger. Oh, I'm so sorry. I'm yawning, just yawning. But I just wanted to catch up with you guys while I had makeup on, because I'm about to take this off. I'm about to take these lashes off at least sit here and watch TV. I am starting to try to enjoy just the downtime of life. It's so important because we're always in a rush. We're always doing something, different things. I just want to chill. Oh, remember I told you guys about the guy that I was seeing, that we stopped seeing each other because he don't want to be married? Well, I had a conversation with him, and I asked him, I was like, why don't you want to be married? And he was like, because he has seen where it's hard to get out of a marriage. So I told him, I was like, you're thinking about the undo of it. And he has real concerns. But for me, I don't think about the undoing of it. I think about the partnership. I think about the love, the support, the person that I can build with. Like, I am so ready for somebody to build with, like to grow with. So, come on. You don't have to want a business. But I have my businesses, and you can help support with that. I'm going to cheer you on with whatever you got going on. Like, I'm ready for that. I'm ready to be able to just cry into your arms and just know that everything is okay. Like, feel safe. Feel safe to just be vulnerable, just to breathe. Me and one of my girlfriends was talking about that one day, and she was like, when she met the dude that she's dating, she just breathed. Like, she was able to exhale. And she was like, she didn't know she needed that. She didn't know she needed that. And so many times, we just need somebody to just tell, make us feel like it's okay. Like, let me know that it's okay. Not just make me. Let me know. Like, really be true blue. Like, I just want somebody genuine. I don't need you thinking about the pain. You know, like, any relationship is going to be something. Like, we're going to go through hardships, but how are we going to handle that? Are we going to talk about it, or are we going to run away? Like, are you going to show me that you want to be here with me? You going to show me that you love me? Or are you going to hide behind the hurt that you've had? Because I've been hurt too. So are you going to walk through this thing? Or are you going to just continue not having anything of substance because you've been hurt before? Or you've seen other people in their situation? It comes a time that if you really want somebody, you have to really put yourself out there. And I'm ready to date seriously. I'm not dating for play. Like, I'm just not. I don't have it in me. I don't have it in me to be with a man who don't know who he is, who's not financially stable. Like, I can't be with that. I can't be with a man that I feel bad by asking him for something, or have it in my mind. Like, I don't even ask you for nothing. Like, I can't be with no man who I have to feel like that. I need to be with a man that I know that he's going to provide for us, for him, for us and his family. He's going to provide. He wants to. Like, he wants to. Like, he has a hunger to take care of me and to love me and our children, because he probably gonna have children. I ain't got none. Like that's what I want. I want somebody who has that mindset of she out here hustling, she out here getting it. Who's not trying to put his foot on my neck? Oh, well, you out here doing all these things. You ain't cook nothing. I mean, I can cook sometimes, but damn, you ain't doing nothing else. This all you do, and I got 50 million things I'm doing. And that's a problem for you. I can't be with nobody like that. And I understand that. And I understand that, you know, I don't knock women who's like that. I don't knock men who want women like that. I'm just not what you want. And I'm okay with that. I'm okay with that. I'm all right. So, yeah. I'm going to sit here kind of just and get prepared for the week, right? So, I'll see y'all later. Bye.
I thank you for it all, the good, bad, the ugly, great and small, the times of victory and when I fall, I'm so grateful that I'm still standing tall. I thank you for my tears, the pain helped me overcome my fears. You've been good to me down throughout the years. It's a miracle that I'm still standing here.
Before you try to come over here fucking with me, please understand I am thick. I'm not that real skinny thick. Like, I'm thick. Like, when I pull up my seat, it go thick, okay?
Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. Let's get social. This has been a Lady CEO production.